You were not looking for that.
Jesus,
oh,
yeah.
I hope you vetted this,
yeah.
Alex.
But you are the youngest that we have.
Don't worry, he gets a little shout out in here. You'll see.
Okay.
That's true, that's true. I had to go check it out. For all the lonely hearts out there, there's a whole new kind of online dating. It involves just staying home, no makeup, just you and your VR headset. That's dating in the metaverse. Craig sounds thrilled. And a few new companies are hoping it'll catch on. Of course, I had to go see this for myself.
This is a duck world where you can feed the ducks.
So have either of you been on a date here?
Oh, I've been on a date here. It was pretty chill.
Feeding ducks, a nature stroll, or even a round of mini golf. Welcome to Dating in the Metaverse, where you can come as yourself, that's me, or a floating robot, all from the comfort of your couch.
This is our Flirtual Speed matching world.
Flirtual is a VR dating app that lets you go on dates with people all over the world in different VR worlds and games.
Anthony Tan and Kyle Farwell are the Gen Zers who run the dating company, which operates similar to a real-life dating app. Users match their profiles via their Apple website, but instead of drinks at a bar in the neighborhood, hopeful singles meet up virtually.
This is where I met my girlfriend 2 years ago.
In this bar.
Yeah.
So when you tell people, would you say we met at a bar?
I guess so.
Luke Smith is a 19-year-old teen in the UK looking for love, both on real-life dating apps and on Flirtual.
It's the same thing with online dating, like a side for the younger generation, but as the older generation got more used to it, they started using it and so on. And I feel like the metaverse will end up being the same way.
Flirtual's not the only one trying to get in on this.
Planet Theta is the world's first dedicated space for virtual reality dating.
Aurora Townsend, the company's chief marketing officer, calls it a safer way to meet up.
It's so normalized that when we, as women, go to like a bar or a restaurant to go meet someone that we met through a dating app, to text multiple friends our exact GPS location to make sure that, hey, if anything sketchy is going on, this is where I am. We want to change that.
Plus, there's the convenience. If you have a busy work week, you know, you can be in your sweatpants with a glass of wine chatting with people. And because you mostly see people as avatars first, fans of VR dating say it can lead to better connections.
Well, they say, you know, you're swiping, you're just seeing their faces. You're not really looking at their personalities.
So, metaverse daters might wait a few dates before revealing their actual faces.
But here, you're getting their exact personality.
So tell me, what is it like dating someone in VR?
It feels very real. You know, I hope this kind of feels pretty real here.
Uh-huh.
Like, I can give Kyle a hug and we can just like...
Oh.
What?
So, can you give me a hug?
Yeah, sure, sure. Right, come here.
Are you kidding me?
Wow, that's funny.
A lot of people experience in VR what we call phantom sense or phantom touch. Where you touch someone in VR and you can feel it.
And now there's somebody that you like that you're talking to in the metaverse.
Absolutely.
So will you try to take that into real life?
I'm hoping to.
Huh.
All right, now the people behind these companies say the metaverse isn't just a great place to meet someone special, but maybe that part's not for you. It can also be a nice way for long-distance couples to stay in touch, feel like you're actually hanging out rather than just talking on the
phone. Wait. But if everybody is an avatar, how is this not a recipe for catfishing? Just people going on pretending who they
are?
Great question. Because, of course, you can make your avatar look like anything you want. I mean, you can be a robot, as you saw in there. So these companies have AI and human moderators to actually look over the profiles constantly, and they have verification systems in place where users can link other accounts. You can link your Instagram, your Facebook, that kind of thing. Luke, the metaverse dater who we saw there, we spoke to, he told us that he likes to FaceTime his dates earlier on so they can see each other's faces. Oh. You know, but there are actually some specific platforms, I know you guys are going to love this part, that's just for people who want to keep it digital only.
Wow.
Wait, whoa.
What would you do that?
That's
so you could have like a real life girlfriend or spouse, and you have another one in the metaverse?
I'm
asking you. I mean,
did you were in the metaverse? Did you guys see each other?
Yeah, where were you?
I need to see R2D2's game.
One of the experts said to me, and I did not consider this, if you are someone who has mobility issues,
yes.
Or if you're shut in,
yes.
This is a great way
to
see and experience a lot. So thank you.
Shameless plug for my piece tomorrow. We're going to get into that when we do.
Well, coming up next, it's very fitting that this next movie we're going to talk about is kind of a game disaster. James Morrison.
I did not have sexual relations with that robot. I don't know anything about it. Thank you very much. Grab her by the pussy.